Ever since the 1960s, mankind has sent robotic spacecraft to explore the solar system. From Mercury and Venus basking in the heat of the sun, to distant Neptune and beyond, we are becoming increasingly familiar with our own cosmic backyard.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ignition and liftoff of the Atlas V with Juno on a trek to Jupiter, a planetary piece of the puzzle from the beginning.
Even now, computerized ambassadors of the human race are blasting off to expand our knowledge of our planetary neighbors. The gas giants with their vast swirling atmospheres and intense radiation belts. Mars, which could soon be the destination of the next step in human spaceflight. We've even begun to explore the multitude of moons in our solar system, where tantalizing evidence suggests that life may exist, the first of its kind outside planet Earth. But what about beyond the solar system? The Milky Way is home to billions of stars, some like our sun, some radically different, but thousands of them with planets and moons of their own. This is Kepler. Orbiting at over 90 million miles from the Sun, it is hunting for exoplanets deep in space. The first exoplanets were discovered in 1992 by listening for tiny changes in the radiation emitted by their parent star. Kepler, though, uses a different method. By gazing unceasingly at over 100,000 stars, the space observatory looks for tiny dips in the light coming from the star as a planet moves in front of it. This decrease in light is somewhat akin to a fly crawling in front of a lighthouse. To normal eyes, and even most telescopes, this minuscule change is completely lost in the incredible glare of the parent star. To date, Kepler has identified over 2,000 possible candidates for planets, and, combined with observations from other telescopes, more than 750 exoplanets have indeed been confirmed. One recent study, in fact, has concluded that on average, every star in the Milky Way is orbited by at least one planet. Many of these planets are sure to be wildly different to our own. Most of those discovered so far orbit extremely close to their parent stars. These so-called hot Jupiters can have surface temperatures of thousands of degrees Kelvin. More recently, scientists have identified planets whose surfaces could be entirely covered in water. One planet is even suspected to be made of diamond. As techniques improve, however, we are beginning to find Earth-like planets. Some of them even reside within the habitable zones of their host stars.
The habitable zone is where we think water will be. If you can find liquid water on the surface, we think we may very well find life there.
Will any of these planets host life? And if so, what might it be like? These profound questions may only be answered by sending a probe to the distant stars. Sending a probe to another star, however, is no mean feat. One such star that might be chosen is Kepler-22, but the first obstacle is the great distances involved. Kepler-22 is estimated to be around 600 light-years away. The fastest space probe mankind has ever built, Voyager 1, would take around 17,500 years to make that journey. Clearly, then, some new technology would have to be imagined, and it is likely to be many years before this could be done. If this hurdle is ever surpassed, though, there will still be many dangers lying in wait for our probe. We do not know precisely what fills the vast spaces between the stars, but there are likely to be micrometeoroids, particles which, although small, will impact at massive velocities, possibly spelling doom for our mission. Radiation in space is also not yet fully understood. Powerful cosmic rays could fry circuits or slowly push the spacecraft off course, leaving it to wander aimlessly in the darkness for eternity. These difficulties, though, whilst tough, are not insurmountable. It is still possible that one day we might land a probe on a world far, far from our own solar system. Will it find life? What images will it send back through the depths of space? Who knows? All we can do is hope that one day our dreams will be realized, and a robotic traveler from Earth will make that maiden voyage to the stars.